Hello my friends, my name is Mohammad Naveed and in this lecture I am going to teach you spelling and grammar, phrasal, word count, translate and language. So first we have spelling grammar. Actually we use it for checking grammar and spelling. For example, if you have written something wrong, for example, and in order to see this, okay, either this is right or wrong, what we need to do, we need to click on this spelling and grammar, and as you can see that it's showing that okay, this spelling DD have no insertion because there is no insertion. But if I type here there's no insertion because this is right, and if I say here this, okay, so As I made this word wrong, as you can see that it now it is giving a solution that okay, the D O C U M E N, this is whatever you have written, this is wrong. We have two solutions. The first is document and second is documents. So what do you want? I say this, so just double click on it, and as you can see that this word has been changed and this word now it is correct. Get me? So we use grammar, spelling grammar, to check our grammar spelling. Definitely to check a grammar and spelling, getting me? Then we have phrasal. What is your phrasal? For example, if I say here, if I say sit, and if I select this and I will click on phrasal, so as you can see that now it's giving us a solution. Okay, here we have the okay, this is fine, sit. But in another word, we can say be seated, sit down, take a seat, getting me? So for example, if I say to someone, okay, sit. So definitely we have three or four ways to say sit down, please sit, getting me? So it is giving us the solution of one word. Then we have word count. For example, if you want to see your word, for example, how many words do you have, how many characters do you have, so in order to see this all, you need to click on word count, and as you can see that now it is showing that how many pages do you have, how many words do you have, how many characters do you have, how many lines, everything it will show you. Then we have translate. For example, if you have a document or a paragraph, for example, and if it is written in Chinese, if you just understand English, so how can you translate this? Definitely with the help of translate menu. How can you translate? First you need to select this and you need to click on translate and translate document, and here is asking that okay, translate form or translate to. Actually, right now I don't have an internet connection, otherwise it will translate for you. First you have translated, okay, this word is written in Chinese, for example, it will give you drop down when you have an internet. Right now I don't have, that's why not showing. And it will say you, okay, this is, it is a translate from Chinese to, translate to English, getting me? So in this way you can translate your document. But right now I don't have internet, that's why it will not translate for us. In the last word we have the language. If you want to change the language, so you can change the language here. But right now I'm using English, you understand English, so no need to change the language, getting me? So this was a lecture on spelling and grammar, phrasal, word count, translate and language. I hope you have understood. For more videos, lecture and exercises, come to my website www.naveedplace.com. Allah Hafiz, and I will meet you in the next lecture. Till then, Allah Hafiz.